Everyone, and welcome to this video clip. In this review note, we're going to be looking at setting up stub routing in iOS. This topology is the same as what we've used for the static routing video clip. If you haven't looked at that yet, or you're not comfortable with static routing, I would suggest you go back and look at that first. Where we are right now, R1 is totally configured up. It knows how to reach both of its directly connected networks plus 10.100.2.0 over here on the right-hand side. However, router 2 is not yet configured to be able to route back. At this point in time with PC1, we should be able to get to both sides of this router because this guy, of course, is connected to both of those networks. But if we try to get out to this router, that's going to fail because this router does not know how to return the traffic. We'll try that out first just to make sure. So here's PC1. I can definitely ping the router's interface on that network where PC1 exists. And I can ping to the far side of the router to which I'm connected. If I try to go through to the next router, that's not going to work. Let's go and fix that over on router 2. On router 2, if I look at my routing table at the moment, I'm going to see the directly connected networks, and that's all, because I've not configured anything else. And sure enough, 10.100.2.0 and then 10.100.255.2. Okay, that's all fine. Normally, we would set up a static route, if we're doing static, for every one of the other networks we have to get to. But in a number of cases, we're going to have something like, say, a branch office, where the only traffic flow that we have is going to go back to the head office. There's no connection off to the internet directly or anything else like that. All traffic flows back to the head office. Meaning that any traffic that's going to go to a remote network must go through the interface that goes back to head office. So instead of giving ourselves a lot of grief and filling up the routing table with a whole bunch of static routes, instead all we have to do is set up the default route, which will point us back to head office, and that's called stub routing. Let me go ahead and do that. Go into a global configuration mode, and all we have to do now is add in the route. Slide is very simple. The default route is always going to have a network with all zero value and a corresponding subnet mask again with all zero value. So we simply add the route in with those values and then point to the IP address that this router connects to send that traffic, which is going to be the IP on the router 1 that directly connects to router 2. Go ahead and enter that command. Look at the routing table. We now see that we have a new static route down at the bottom. And if you look up at the top of the output of the command, we can also see the gateway of last resort, or the default gateway if you want, has been set. We should now be in a position that we can ping all the way through from PC1 into PC2. Go back over here into PC1. We can see that that ping to the second router has failed all the way through. Let's retry that. And we can see that that is successful. And if we try to ping through to PC2, we can see that that's a successful as well. On router 2, we now have a very, very small routing table, about as efficient as you can possibly get, which means the processing on that router is going to be that much faster because there's much less to parse in the routing table to determine how to forward packets. So, wrap for the video. Hopefully this has been helpful for you. And we'll see you next time.